Es Yes, why do we need to study the past? Why do we need to study about all these practices? Nobody does these nowadays, so why should we know? Of course, yes, we have discovered the mummy of King Tut, and we want to really know about it. Our curiosity is there, that why and how he died at such a young age. So we also need to know about the customs and the culture and, of course, the prevailing practices of that time. Right? It always adds to our knowledge. Yes, over there, last two boys, please wear your mask properly. Yeah. Sit straight. Sit attentively in the class. I don't like droopy faces. Sit smartly. Yes, over there also. Who's there behind Deepak? Aditya, who else? Aditya, get up, please. Come on the first bench. Let's see you attentive. Come on. Come here. You know how to wear a mask? You should wear it like this. Don't wear it just for showing. Wear it properly. Okay? Yeah. So what did we discuss yesterday? Where have we reached? So they have, we read about the discovery of King Tut. Who was the archaeologist, the British archaeologist who discovered? Howard Carter. Very good. And of course, Howard Carter did something very, damaging also to the body. What was it that he did? Yeah, he removed, disengaged or severed the joints, right? So he removed that but he assembled everything. But he gave a very valid explanation. What was it? That otherwise all the jewelry would have been removed and the damage would have been done even more by, gold diggers. So that was his justification, right? Then what do we learn about the history of this dynasty, this very important dynasty, this very powerful dynasty that King Tut belonged to? What do we learn about? We learned about his ancestor. Who was that? Amenhotep. Yes, three, and then Amenhotep IV came to the throne. He made a lot of changes, changed his name, changed the kingdom, changed the god they worshipped, and even damaged many major temples, right? So, of course, that was maybe one of the craziest time during that dynasty's reign. Then when King Tut ascended the throne, there was one person also in between. Yes, Menkheres, so not much is learned about him. Then when he ascended the throne, he got a kingdom, or he got that dynasty which had a lot of problems at hand. So there were so many things that had been changed. So he restored the old practices. He restored the old traditions, right? So whether it was about the prayers, the worshipping, and the name, right? So not their worshipping of the sun dish, but they considered themselves as a living image of God. That is why so much of important to the Pharaohs, okay? So this much we have done. So we had also discussed about an X-ray and about a CT scanner. X-ray gives a two-dimensional picture. And after Howard Carter, scientists, they had done the X-ray of this mummy. What did they find? They found the ribs, a few ribs, and the breastbone was missing, right? So it led to more speculations that what could have been the cause of death, isn't it? Right? So what happened at the beginning of the chapter? What was there happening at the beginning of the chapter? The mummy being taken out of the coffin and going to go for a CT scan, right? And what was the scenario there? What was the atmosphere like? The wind blowing, the dust clouds, and of course creating that fear. The mind of the people as well as the scientists. So sometimes, no matter how much, educated or scientifically oriented we call ourselves, there comes that moment in our lives, there comes a little time in our lives that sometimes we also start questioning, or we also start having a faith in the various kinds of beliefs. So people were there a little scared. Oh my God, what's happening? It's the curse of the Pharaoh. So everybody was affected at that moment. Now let's read here. Yes, all of you open to your books and let's continue with our reading. Okay. So regardless of this fame and the speculation of about his fate, we had read this, that how King Tut is ahead in life as well as in death. How was he ahead in life? Yes, he became the Pharaoh at a very young age. And of course, one of the most powerful dynasties, right? And in death also, how was he ahead? He was, it was the first mummy that was put through the CT scanner. Of course, also because, yeah, one of the most lavish funerary treasures, right? It is there as per the Pharaoh's standards or the Egyptian standard, it was very, very lavish, okay? Right, so he was ahead of his countrymen. Now next, let's see here. A CT machine scanned the mummy head to toe, creating 1700 digital X-ray images in cross-section. So what is the major difference between the X-ray and the CT scanner? X-ray is two-dimensional, CT scanner is three-dimensional. And on the screen, as the mummy goes through the CT scanner, so there's a picture on the computer screen. And you've seen how scanning happens, isn't it? Like when you, the ultrasound and things like that, right? So when the image is created on the screen. And you can look at it from all the angles. So very clear picture is there. So what happened? Creating 1700 digital X-ray images in cross-section. I asked you also, like when you see your slides also in the lab. Tut's head scanned in 0.62 millimeter slices, little slices, the head there, and appearing in front to register its intricate structures. Takes on eerie detail in the resulting image. What was there covered under those herbs and raisins and the bandages, right? So many years ago, you see that on the screen. What is eerie detail? Eerie is scary, that spooky kind of a feeling, isn't it? Yeah. So like you feel very amazed that somebody lived so many years ago and you're able to see, right? With Tut's entire body similarly recorded, a team of specialists in radiology, forensics, and anatomy began to probe the secrets that the winged goddesses of a gilded burial shrine protected for so long. This body had been kept secret for so long. No one should disturb. Let that person go on, you know, like wherever the soul goes and the belief that they had in afterlife. But scientists do not let anyone rest in peace. So they'll break all traditions, they'll break all cult, you know, like beliefs also for their scientific curiosity. So they've taken it out. And a body that had been protected for so long by the religious beliefs and practices, the gods, goddesses, look at it, to probe the secrets that the winged goddesses of a gilded burial shrine protected for so long. Gilded burial shrine, gold plated, covered in gold. Right? Yes. So here it is there. And of course, with all the structures and all the murals, all the paintings made in the tomb. And they had protected this child of theirs. They had protected this very, young king of theirs. But scientists did not bother about that. They've taken out and looking at the CT scanner. The night of the scan, workmen carried Tut from the tomb in his box. Like pall bearers, they climbed a ramp and a flight of stairs into the swirling sand outside. Pall bearers, people who carry the coffin. Coffin, they carry, you know, like when a person dies, so there are people carrying the dead body. So the pall bearers are that. So like a pall bearer, of course, they're carrying the dead body only, right? So these workers, they carried it out. They climbed a ramp and a flight of stairs into the swirling sand outside. Swirling sand. Why was the sand swirling? What was happening outside? What had happened to the weather? The wind was blowing. So the sand was blowing. then rose on a hydraulic lift into a trailer that held the scanner. Hydraulic lift. So it lifted that body, you know, like, and it went into the scanner. Okay. 20 minutes later, two men emerged, sprinted for an office nearby, and returned with a pair of white plastic fans. The million-dollar scanner had quit because of sand in a cooler fan. So, right, so the scanner had stopped working. Why? Because sand had got into the fans, right? Curse of the Pharaoh, joked a guard nervously. So, yeah, as I told you, like that fear was in their mind. That curse was there in the mind. And what are they afraid of? Aray, the fan has stopped working. The CT scanner is not working. Why is it happening? Is it because of the curse? Right? So it is making their belief even more stronger. Okay? What else had happened and make them believe like that? The wind blowing, isn't it? So eventually, the substitute fans worked well enough to finish the procedure. After checking that no data had been lost, the technicians turned Tut over to the workmen who carried him back to his tomb. So they did the scan. They were quite sure that, okay, nothing has been lost. And because in between it had stopped, and then the mummy was taken back to his tomb. Less than 3 hours after he was removed from his coffin, the pharaoh again rested in peace where the funerary priests had laid him so long ago. So it just took 3 hours. Right, took the mummy out of the coffin, went to the CT scanner and back again. But those 3 hours, how much you can say what tension was there and so much of pressure there, right, that everything should go well. Back in the trailer, a technician pulled up astonishing images of Tut on a computer screen. A gray head took shape from a scattering of pixels. So we all are aware of what pixels are, right? So all those images coming together and yes, what was it? A gray head. And the technician spun and tilted it in every direction. Neck vertebrae appeared as clearly as in an anatomy class. So how well they might have been preserved. Everything visible so clearly, right? Other images revealed a hand, several views of the rib cage, and a transection of the cell. So yes, so there was this image of the skull also. But for now, the pressure was off. But everybody is relieved. Okay, thank God the CT scan is done and everything went calmly and peacefully. Sitting back in his chair, Zahi Hawass smiled visibly. Zahi Hawass was the person in charge. It was his responsibility. He's there in charge of the museum over there, the curator. Visibly relieved that nothing had gone seriously wrong. But thank God no damage happened and nothing was delayed for so long. I didn't sleep last night, not for a second, he said. I was so worried, but now I think I will go and sleep. He's so relieved. Big burden off his head. By the time we left the trailer, descending metal stairs to the sandy ground, the wind had stopped. The winter air lay cold and still like death itself. There was stillness, nothing moving, like death. In this valley of the departed, because this valley of the kings, it was where all the dead were buried, right? Yes. Just above the entrance to Tut's tomb stood Orion, the constellation that the ancient Egyptians knew as the soul of Osiris, the god of the afterlife, watching over the boy king. Can anyone just read this last line and tell me how is it important? Who has been guarding the king for so long? Which, as I told you, the pyramids were made in such a way that they pointed towards that constellation. In particular, which constellation here? Yes, the Osiris, right? And of course, that was the god of afterlife. And the god of afterlife making sure that, yes, nothing happens to this body, okay? And so if you just turn back and look at it here, so we have here, there's a mural in King Tut's tomb that's showing King Tut with Osiris. So he's been handed over now. who's going to take care of this king in the afterlife? The god of afterlife, that is Osiris. Okay, so once again, it's a blend of the past and the present, right? Is this clear? What was the main thing? The scanning. And of course, we have read about the beliefs. We have read about the history. We have read about the fears. We have read what the CT scan revealed. And of course, the CT scan did not reveal much more than what the X-ray showed. Now, main question was the mystery surrounding his death. And later on, it was found out that he died a natural death. It was like people thought about conspiracies and things like that. I've shared a video with you all yesterday also, which was about this, only taking it out, right? And of course, we can find out much more material there if you're really very curious to know that what was the cause of his death, okay? Right? So, of course, it was a natural death only that he died. And the curiosity was, why did he die at such a young age? That is why so much of things were done. Okay, let's go to the questions here. King Tut's body has been subjected to repeated scrutiny. Why do you think King Tut's body has been subjected to repeated scrutiny? Because Bar-bar, why are people there observing it again and again? Why is it being taken out and studied? Why so much of attention? Curiosity, because he was, the last pharaoh of one of the most powerful dynasties, and he died at a young age. That is why Howard Carter's investigation was resented. Resent, not liked. What did Howard Carter do that people did not like? Yes, very good. So he took out the mummy from its coffin, or rather he kept it out under the sun. He thought the raisins would melt. Did it happen? No. But he wanted to remove all the ornaments and everything. So he chiseled the body, right? And he caused a lot of damage. So that is the problem people had. Why did Carter have to chisel away the solidified raisins to raise the king's remains? Why did he have to chisel it away? To remove the body out of the coffin, and of course to take off all the gold ornaments that were there, to prevent more damage by ignorant people who come there hunting for gold. Tut's body was buried along with gilded treasures. Yes, as it was a belief. And of course, according to the stature of that person, he was a pharaoh, right? He died as a very young pharaoh from one of the most powerful dynasties. Okay, right. Yes, next is, the boy changed his name from Tutankhaten to Tutankhamun. Why did he change his name? Yes, to restore the older practices which had been changed by his, ancestors. So to restore the normal or the old system that had been happening. Okay, so he was there once again, the living image of God. List the deeds that led Ray Johnson to describe Akhenaten as wacky. What did Akhenaten do? What did he do? Change the name, change the capital, change the god, right? So all these things were crazy. Yes, and damage some temples. Very good. What were the results of the CT scan? What were the results of the CT scan? So everything was very clearly visible. Skull was visible, the vertebrae visible, everything very, very clearly visible. And of course, it showed the same thing, that the rib and the breastbone was missing, right? It did not show much damage to any other part. So even the neck vertebrae were very, very clearly. So if someone had tried to hurt that person, you think, okay, maybe trying to, you know, like as in the murder or some kind of conspiracy, there would have been damage elsewhere also, right? It was not there. List advances in technology that have improved forensic analysis. Let's think about all crime patrol and CID and everything that you've seen. So forensic analysis, what are the techniques that have been used? Last boys, can you just sit properly here? What are the techniques? One is here. You have the CT scanner. right? What other techniques are used for forensic analysis? So we have DNA, that testing and all, isn't it? Right, matching of that. Yeah. Yes. So the like, of course, here it is, like your carbon dating and like, of course, all these here finding the very advanced techniques which have been used. Explain the statement, King Tut is one of the first mummies to be scanned in death as in life. We have discussed this, I think so. Do I need to discuss this again? Do I need to discuss this again? Yes. Okay. Now let us just go through these topics. These are very, very important topics for discussion. This, the next week, you're going to have a test of this chapter, right? I might give one subjective question, and I, of course, others might be your multiple choice questions. Okay, right. So last week you did not have. This week we'll start with our tests also. Okay. So this chapter has to be thoroughly, thoroughly read. If there is going to be a lot of confusion also, right? So please, yeah, Nalini, you have any problem? No problem. You have a problem with the test? Kind of. क्यों नहीं आने चाहिए इंग्लिश में आएंगे हाँ we'll get in English. Scientific intervention is necessary to unearth buried mysteries. Why is the use of scientific techniques important to unearth buried mysteries? Science will give us what? Accuracy. Yes, that is why. What else? Information about that the practices or why these things took place, is it right? Yeah, easy ho jata hai, and it, yes, of course, you have a lot of variety of techniques which are used, right? So it gives a more clearer picture rather than just guesswork. So scientific techniques. Now, advanced technology gives us conclusive evidence of past events. So this is a kind of an overlapping thing here. So technology, right? So where you are able to date everything particular, you know, very accurately, you're able to find out the exact information. And of course, a very, very clear picture we are able to create about our past. And technology, yes. So all aspects, they can be studied. It's not only one aspect that you're looking into. You can look into the various aspects of it. Traditions, rituals, and funerary practices must be respected in the light of this chapter. They must be respected. So what happened here in this chapter? Did they respect those funerary practices? No. Should they be respected? Once a person has been laid to rest, is it right to dig that person out of his grave? So he's already dead, doesn't know what is happening. Is it? Could be. But what about the religious beliefs there that are associated with all the funerary practice? What? Yeah. So, of course, otherwise we should not. It is only in very exceptional circumstances. Maybe you need some queries to be answered. Maybe that is a very important link in a part of the mystery, right? So, you need that information for some other, you can say, investigation that is going on. So, we have read about, even in modern times also, how dead bodies have been exhumed, right, to identify that person for the DNA testing and all, everything has been done, isn't it, right? So, but otherwise, funerary practices, they need to be respected. People deserve dignity in life as well as in death. So we must make sure of that, right? So we have realized, I think so, this. Now, knowledge about the past is useful to complete our knowledge of the world we live in. Yeah, Garv, Nalin, who's going to give me the answer? Yes, knowledge of the past is useful to complete our knowledge of the world we live in. We are so happy living in this world. Why do we want to learn about future? Why should we learn about the past? So why should we study? We have one more chapter to learn. So we can manage without that. So it is very important to be a part of our learning. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Say yes in everything that ma'am is saying. You don't give your opinion, isn't it? We don't have any opinion. Ma'am, we've stopped thinking long time ago. Same opinion? So it is important to learn about the past. Okay, carry on with your yes, ma'am. Right? So it is important to learn about the past so that we